May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Nick.
Let's go talk to Amari.
Here for Amari? She's downstairs.
Dr. Amari?
Yes? Wait, I remember you. The memory inducement. Vault 111, right? What's this all about?
You're the one who can extract memories from a brain, right?
Normally, we only allow our clients to experience their own memories. Now, what's this all about?
We need a deep dig, Amari, but it's not gonna be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you two mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
How much of the brain do you need exactly?
That is not an encouraging question. I suppose I'll have to make do with whatever you can find.
Could you say that like Dr. Frankenstein?
Igor, fetch me the brain! No?
No, I will not. Now, do you have it?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Nick's an older model synth. Is he compatible?
That's exactly what I was thinking. If we are lucky, it should hook right in. But even if this works, Mr. Valentine would be taking on a tremendous amount of risk. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. Let's do it.
You really think this'll work, Nick?
No idea. But we got a missing kid on the line. That's worth the risk.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Hancock.
You look like you
could use a little
pick me up.
Your thoughts?
Don't worry. You're in good hands with Amari. It's been weeks since she's cooked anyone's gourd.
Your thoughts?
Reliable guns are always at a premium in the Commonwealth.
Static. I can't make sense of any.
Your thoughts?
Most folks just don't know real living. Not like this.
It appears the Institute.
More problems. Seriously?
It's not like anyone has ever done this before. You try making a secret technology work across hardware generations out of spare parts. Just let me think. The encryption is probably meant to keep a single mind from accessing the data. So, what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Nick and I are gonna share a mind? Yeah, I'm not gonna see him in any compromising positions, am I?
Yeah, if a smart mouth was all it took to solve problems, we would have found your son by now.
No. You won't have to worry about that. The only memories you'll access are the ones in the implant.
Any idea what I'm gonna see in there?
I have no clue. But considering we only have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain, I doubt it'll be cohesive.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some